The next generation of text-to-video synthesis has finally arrived, and it's not just another unusable AI model being teased by a large corporation, but instead it's designed to be both lightweight and accessible to average users, with the code and model weights coming to GitHub. Enter Show-1, a state-of-the-art hybrid model that is promising to redefine the landscape of text-based video generation. But what makes it stand out as such a winner in text-to-video synthesis? See, traditionally, text-to-video generation methodologies bifurcated into two primary categories: pixel-based video diffusion models and latent-based video diffusion models. The only problem is that pixel-based VDMs, while exceptionally adept at generating text-correlated videos, are infamous for their exorbitant computational requirements, meaning that they provide precision but at a serious cost of efficiency. Conversely, latent-based VDMs, operating in a reduced dimension latent space, are far more resource efficient. However, this efficiency often comes at the expense of detailed and accurate text-to-video alignment, especially in scenarios demanding high-resolution outputs. Thus, the core challenge was the establishment of a balance, a model that could synergize the precision of pixel-based systems with the efficiency of latent-based systems. And this is exactly where Show-1 steps in to bridge the gap, by ingeniously integrating the strengths of both pixel-based and latent-based VDMs. Impressively, its architecture is founded on a dual-stage approach. The first stage initiates with pixel-based VDMs for generating a low-resolution video with impeccable text-video correlation. Then, the second stage utilizes an innovative expert translation mechanism, relying on latent-based VDMs to upscale this low-resolution output, achieving a high-resolution result. This combination ensures that Show-1 can produce high-quality videos characterized by precise text-to-video alignments. Moreover, it achieves this with just a fraction of the computational overhead when benchmarked against conventional pixel-based VDMs. For example, GPU memory usage during inference with Show-1 is 15 gigabytes as opposed to 72 gigabytes. In fact, upon rigorous benchmarking against standalone methods, Show-1's efficacy proved undeniable. In comparative assessments with purely latent VDMs, Show-1's generated videos stood out in both quality and text alignment. When juxtaposed against pixel-based counterparts, the efficiency metrics, particularly computational resource utilization, were unparalleled. Furthermore, Show-1 isn't an isolated system, as it benefits from an extensive dataset comprising numerous video examples. Importantly, this reservoir of data aids Show-1 in comprehending diverse textual prompts, ensuring the resultant videos are not just high quality, but also semantically coherent. It's a breakthrough because Show-1 is the world's first text-to-video generation that isn't a trade-off between quality and efficiency, but rather a harmonious blend of both. Moreover, as the field of AI continues its rapid evolution, models like Show-1 exemplify the kind of innovative thinking that will push the boundaries, with this model's introduction prompting a re-evaluation of existing methodologies and beckoning a future where the seamless conversion of text to video is suddenly within reach. But it's still important to understand that while Show-1 has indeed set a new benchmark, the journey of refining and enhancing text to video synthesis is still ongoing. And as AI researchers continue to explore and experiment, models like Show-1 will likely serve as both an inspiration and a foundation for what's to come. Meanwhile, Show-1 is just the beginning, because in the second story, the quest for hyper-realistic, high-definition rendering has just experienced its biggest breakthrough yet, thanks to a new paradigm in the area of neural radiance fields, also known as NeRFs for short. For the uninitiated, AI-powered neural radiance fields learn from input images to create 3D models of a scene, allowing for the generation of completely new views of that scene without the need for 3D reconstruction. Essentially, NeRFs turn 2D photos into 3D environments. However, the dream of achieving high-quality real-time 1080p rendering has remained largely elusive until now. Enter the world of 3D Gaussian splatting, the groundbreaking innovation unveiled at the revered SIGGRAPH conference by a trailblazing French team. This method has not only achieved state-of-the-art radiance field rendering, but also managed to strike the elusive balance between rapid training and exceptional real-time HD output. The result? A technique that's creating ripples in the graphics community and promises to turbocharge a gamut of nerf-centric applications. But what makes this new method of 3D Gaussian splatting truly stand out? For the uninitiated, splats in programming languages like JavaScript or Python denote multiple arguments or elements. The term splat, quite evocatively, illustrates the operation of spreading out the values it embodies. This concept, while not novel, has been ingeniously repurposed to provide refined image blurring, sophisticated texture mapping, and hyper-realistic computer simulations. See, with 3D Gaussian splats, gone are the traditional polygons or triangles used to delineate an object. Instead, we see a bunch of Gaussians, which are like blurry 3D shapes, helping to create a much more vivid, lifelike representation of the scene. But this process, while sophisticated, is also remarkably intuitive. It all begins with sparse points derived during camera calibration, epitomizing the scene with 3D Gaussians. Employing the well-established structure from motion methodology, a 3D point cloud is extrapolated from a series of 2D snapshots. Each of these points then metamorphoses into a Gaussian. It all begins with sparse points derived during camera calibration, epitomizing the scene with 3D Gaussians. Employing the well-established structure from motion methodology, a 3D point cloud is extrapolated from a series of 2D snapshots. Each of these points then metamorphoses into a Gaussian. To elevate these results to top-tier quality, the model undergoes a training regimen. But here lies another marvel of 3D Gaussian splats, its lightning-fast training. Shunning the cumbersome, deep layers characterizing many AI techniques, this approach leverages stochastic gradient descent, streamlining the training procedure and dramatically ramping up its speed. But there's more. This methodology thrives on a razor-sharp feedback mechanism. If the gradient signals a discrepancy, the system deftly navigates its way, splitting or cloning the Gaussian or tweaking its alpha. This intuitive rasterization error training strategy adeptly optimizes volumetric radiance fields and therefore sidesteps redundant computations while focusing on precision and quality. The results? Unparalleled speed, a drastic reduction in errors, and an amazingly clear output. However, every silver lining has a cloud. The technique is voracious when it comes to VRAM on GPUs, with most of the showcased 3D Gaussian splats work demanding high-end NVIDIA cards equipped with a staggering 24 gigabytes of RAM, not to mention the substantial disk space requirements. But, as with all cutting-edge tech, refinements are inevitable. Although currently static, the dynamic potential of 3D Gaussian splats is palpable, with viewers, tools, and 3D Gaussian splatting implementations already surfacing on platforms like Unity and Unreal Engine. The future of graphics rendering looks not just promising, but utterly transformative.